found his way back onto the football field, but in an interesting way Saturday night. The 2012 Heisman Trophy winner made his debut in the fan-controlled football league as a member of the Zappers. Manziel completed just one of his five passes on the night for 11 yards, but he did run for a touchdown as the Zappers fell to the Beast. So, Shannon, what was your reaction to Manziel playing his first game in this league?
Sad. What could have been? Skip, he was electric. I don't know, have we ever seen in that Saturday afternoon in Tuscaloosa, when he burst onto the scene, and from that moment on, you're like, man, this kid is special. And then you watch him in the bowl games, and then you watch him all of a sudden just, and with more fame, the more he became out there, and that it was all about the celebrity and not the game. And you just think, and you think about 2012, Jenny mentioned that he won the Heisman, and here we are 2021, and he played in that league. It's sad that a guy that has so much ability just wasted it. He didn't care. And for me, the way I look at it, Skip, when guys don't care, I don't care either. I used to tell my kids this all the time. I can't want something more than you want it for yourself. So me wanting this, if this is not what you want, we're wasting our time. So pick out something that you want, wherever you want to go to school, whatever you want to major in, do that. Because I don't want you to get to be 30 and say, well, Dad, I only did this because you wanted me to. Hell no, you didn't. Your dad lived his life. Your dad did what he wanted to do. Do what you want to do. When Johnny Manziel did exactly what he wanted to do. He wanted to be good at football for a little while, party, have a good old time, talk about, oh, Robbie, you know, do this right here, party all day, all night. Just like he said after the game, Skip, we lose, we booze. He thought that was cute. Nice catchphrase. Bro, do you realize people laugh at you? They laugh at you. You're a joke. And you wasted all this ability for what? For so long, Skip, in high school, they made excuses for Johnny, and Johnny Manziel's money could get him out of anything.
That's true.
And his ability could get him out of anything. They made the excuses for him at the very thing that they suspended Todd Gurley for. They suspended him for half a game. The man said, oh, he signed 4,000 items for free. Really? As a Heisman Trophy winner, Skip.
He did.
But that just goes to show you.
A half a game against Rice.
And Todd Gurley. Todd Gurley missed, what, four games. They suspended A.J. Green for the same thing because they had a jersey. Man, this is...
He was the biggest draw in college football.
He was, Skip.
And they knew it.
What is this? Skip, he played in this. What is this? Some beer league? I don't have...
The fan-controlled football league. The Zappers.
Skip, this is... This should be beneath Johnny. Skip, this is embarrassing.
So, to your point, if you told me during the 2012 college football season that Johnny Manziel would wind up playing in the fan-controlled football league in 2021, I would have laughed in your face. This kid? Are you kidding? He was on his way as a redshirt freshman. It was his first year starting to winning the Heisman Trophy.
He won the Heisman Trophy, Skip.
He beat St. Nick at Tuscaloosa, 29-24. He threw a late touchdown pass on a corner route where I just said, that's just too good. He was fearless. And against my Oklahoma Sooners in the Cotton Bowl that year.
Oh, he beat the brakes off, y'all.
Lord have mercy. 516 total yards. He threw for 287, but that's not what. He rushed for 229. That was on 17 carries. That's 13.5 yards a carry. Every time he took off, he was just gone.
He beat the brakes off, y'all.
Against Mike Stoops' defense. He was the coordinator. I'm just like, what are you doing? Don't you understand who he is? They knew going in what he was, and they couldn't deal with it.
You're right.
They were co-winners of the Big 12, and they couldn't deal with it. So he wins a Heisman Trophy, and then right away in the offseason, I'm like, Johnny, what are you doing? First thing we hear about, he goes to the University of Texas, their rival school, A&M versus Texas. In the old days, back in the old Southwest Conference days, it's their blood rivals. And he goes to Austin to the University of Texas and raids a frat party and causes a fight. You think he was in his right mind when he did that?
No.
No, he was not. And I began to read about it. He's got, you know, he drinks hard liquor already. He's a, you know, he's into, when they win or lose, they booze. In fact, could we hear that little clip from after the game the other night with the Zappers?
We'll keep getting better as the weeks go on, but good start, even with the loss. No win or lose, we booze on the Zappers.
Okay, that just summed him up because he had issues with alcohol, which I believe led to some issues with drugs. And in the end, you nailed it. He prioritized partying over playing professional football.
Yeah.
And he admits now, I just never really wanted to play professional football. It wasn't my goal.
It wasn't his dream. Yeah.
No, it wasn't his dream. And so he goes to Cleveland. Houston had the first overall pick. And again, I was pushing. I said, if I'm Houston, I'm thinking hard about him because he played at College Station, which is just right up the road from Houston.
Even what you call him, John Gruden, who he was on ESPN at the time, said, hey, I would take it, but I wouldn't look back.
And he said that on the show I was on, which was First Take. At that point, John Gruden flat out said that when I asked him, I'm not going to look back. I'm taking that kid. Wow, you are.
Yeah.
Interesting.
And you'd have been fired.
Okay. And I thought my Cowboys would be intrigued, and I think Jerry wanted to do it so badly. And they're sitting at 16, and he went 22nd overall. And I believe Stephen Jones, it's almost become legendary,
Zach Martin.
Did say, Jerry, we can't do this.
Because that's probably what he said to Jerry, because they called him Jerry. They don't call his dad.
Jerry. He calls his dad Jerry. Jerry, we just can't. We can't. Because they had Zach Martin rated, like, at the top of their board.
And plus, the thing is, Skip, when you, these first-round picks, these teams have spent so much money, they know everything you've done. They don't talk to your teachers. You don't know anything about it. They don't talk to your friends. They don't walk up to talk to some of your friends, and they think that's a total. You think that's a total stranger.
Yep.
But that's somebody in the organization getting a feel for what you like. And the guy, what's the receiver, Skip, from Oklahoma State, came out the dais, went to Jacksonville.
Yeah.
Blackman.
Yeah, Blackman.
Skip, guy says, hey.
He had issues too.
Went to the bar. He said every day, I went for a week. He was at the same bar at the same time drinking.
Yep. Okay.
We took him off our board. All Jacksonville right. took him within a year out of the league.
That is true. So right now, Texas A&M fills up a 103,000-seat stadium that is the house that Johnny
That's
built.
The house.
103,000 seats was because of this kid.
Mm-hmm.
He just ignited a great tradition. He sort of reignited.
Reignited, yeah.
Yes. And I'm thinking, okay. And remember, Dal Loggins was the quarterback coach in Cleveland.
Yeah.
And he's the one who, legend has it, around the draft table.
Draft table.
Talked the owner into, hey, he showed him a text from Johnny. Take me. And the
quote wreck the
was,
league.
Let's wreck the league. You're going to wreck the... No, you're not going to
wreck... your franchise.
You're going to wreck yourself, which he quickly did.
He did.
He said he didn't study. He didn't care. He's partying.
Well, that became very obvious.
Right? And he lived in a hotel. Then he had all kinds of domestic issues. It was one thing after another after another. And I have to watch him on Saturday, whatever it was, night. I didn't watch it. I just saw the clips.
Yeah.
That he's playing for the Zappers? What? And look at his quotes. Feels like I'm super washed up, but I still had a blast. Because that was he was having fun playing football because nobody cared.
Right.
There's no pressure.
You are super washed up. You didn't lie.
That was the most fun I've had in a while, he said. He was laughing about it. You see me get caught from behind? Oh, like it was funny to him. Boy, times have changed. This definitely is 2021. And in the game, he went 1 of 5 for 11 yards throwing.
Yeah.
Okay?
The man said, I'm super washed up. Mm-hmm. He's like, he knows it.
But he enjoyed it because nobody cared. No pressure.
Nope.
It's like backyard football, and I guess that's what he wanted to play. That's where he was at his best playing, quote-unquote, backyard football.
Yeah.
And
he liked to play the Turkey Bowl, Skip, with the old guys getting together on Thanksgiving.
Yeah,
that like used that. To play football to play the Turkey Bowl.
No, you're,
that's
what you're
he,
right.
That's a televised Turkey Bowl.
Wow. It's just so sad. And he became best friends with Josh Gordon.
Yep.
They lived a whole offseason together out here in Los Angeles, mm-hmm. in West Hollywood. They got an apartment together. And it was some crazy times because they were clubbing every night.
Think about it, Skip. He was taking pictures with LeBron,
yep.
Drake.
He was.
In the offseason.
He was.
A kid in college. This kid in college.
LeBron and loved him.
You're taking pictures with Drake?
Yeah.
With LeBron?
Yeah.
You front row of NBA Finals game and you're everywhere.
Everywhere. He was something. He was a celebrity.
Yes.
Of the highest order. And he's still got, like, it kid about him. I'm sure when he still goes to the club is all gaga over Johnny Manziel just came in. Football.
What could have been? I mean, I'm sure they're going to do a story, one of those, Skip, where are they now and what could have been? You know, one of these 30 for 30s or something like that. He's going to be a prime candidate.
You know, I got to know him fairly well. And I got to tell you, if you're around him, he's fun to be around.
Right.
Seems like a pretty good guy and smart as a whip. Just smart as a whip. And you and waste this. All that?
He wasted it.
Come on. Really? Yeah, one day he'll wake up and say, what was I thinking?
Oh, it's hard. At first, it's kind of funny, and then when you guys talk about how sad it is, it really is. I honestly just hope that he is well. Like, that's what I keep thinking about. I know he struggled in the past. I hope he's healthy. And if he's saying and having a good time, then really at this point, what else is there for him to be doing right now, guys? I'm going to transition to this.